Well, if you got a wound,
yeah,
you don't cover it.
Yeah.
And say, it's all right, I don't see it now, you know, it's
yeah.
Or it's, no, the, actually, come to think of it, I've been very impressed, actually,
yes,
by the development of radio stations in African languages.
You know,
I don't even call them vernacular. I think it's important we call them Kenyan languages, because we need to see them positively as Kenyan,
yes,
rather than something else other than...
Okay.
But vernacular has no problem, but really it's got a bit of editorializing about it relative to, you know, language.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. You leave people the impression that African language are vernaculars,
yeah,
but English and Kiswahili are languages.
Yeah.
I've been encouraged by the rise of vernacular languages. And on YouTube, I've seen incredible performances in African languages, Kenyan languages in particular. I've seen films in Gikuyu, for instance, and over the years I've seen a really good improvement in camera work,
yes,
and editing and so on. But now they are even making better films, you know, and I've seen films by, I think, by Kanyanya stars,
yeah,
really very well edited, you know, in camera work is really excellent. Acting is really very good, you know, and very smooth and so on.
Yeah.
And I'm very impressed that the, I think the woman director, producer, is a woman whose name is, I think it's her name is, I remember her name in a minute.
Yes.
Yeah. Lucy Mugabe, I think,
yes,
yeah.
Yes.
And apparently she used to be a gospel singer, you know. I've been very impressed by that. And also other comedies in different languages.
Mm.
I was watching the other day his comedy in Kisi, in Ekegusi language, and
yes,
so on. So that side of music, you know, actually the best music is the one now being produced in African languages. So that side of it is very, very positive. But we cannot leave our languages merely as only oral or just for music, or but this should be part of the intellectual production of our, you know, communities. You know, I know there are difficulties. We have problems because our languages have not really been part of the school curriculum.
Yes.
Or if they have been, they have been marginalized. You know, I know of cases where teachers would have, say, the hour assigned for African languages.
Yes.
They sometimes use it for English practice,
yes,
which already send a message to the kids, the children,
yes,
that their language is not important.
Not